To the town of Avebury, who rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24, and the notches on his pistol numbered 1 and 19 more.
1 and 19 more.
Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. Was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red.
After Texas Red.
Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, men that tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death.
About to meet his death.
There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas Red had not cleared leather or a bullet fairly ripped. And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
Big iron. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
All day I face the barren waste, without the taste of water, cool water. Old Dan and I, with throats burned dry and souls that cry for water, cool, clear water.
The nights are cool, and I'm a fool. Each star's a pool of water, cool water.
And with the dawn I'll wake and yawn and carry on to water, cool, clear water.
Dan, don't you listen to him, Dan. He's the devil, not a man. And he spreads the burning sand with water.
Dan, can you see that big green tree where the water's running free and it's waiting there for you and me? Water. The shadows sway and seem to say, tonight we pray for water, cool water. And way up there he'll hear our prayer and show us where there's water.
Moving, Dan, don't you listen to him, Dan. He's the devil, not a man. And he spreads the burning sand with water.
Dan, can you see that big green tree where the water's running free and it's waiting there for you and me? Water.
Song of Billy the Kid. I'll sing of some desperate deeds that he did. Way out in New Mexico, long, long ago, when a man's only chance was his old 44. When Billy the Kid was a very young lad, in old Silver City, he went to the bat. Way out in the West with a gun in his hand, at the age of 12 years he did kill his first man. There's Mexican maidens play guitars and sing songs about Billy, their boy bandit king. Ere his young manhood has reached its sad end, with a notch on his pistol for 21 men. Was on a sad night when poor Billy died. He said to his friends, I'm not satisfied. There's 21 men I have put bullets through. Sheriff Pat Garrett must make 22. I'll sing you how Billy the Kid met his fate. The bright moon was shining, the hour was late. Shot down by Pat Garrett, who once was his friend. The young outlaw's life has now come to an end. There's many a man with a face fine and fair, who start out in life with a chance to be square. Just like poor Billy, they wander astray. They'll lose their lives in the very same way.
I got 160 acres in the valley. Got 160 acres of the best. Got an old stove there that'll cook three square, and a bunk where I can lay me down to rest. Up at dawn to greet the sun, I've forgotten what a care or worry means. Head for home when day is done, with my pocket money jingling in my jeans. I've got 160 acres full of sunshine, got 160 million stars above, got
not an old paid hoss. I'm the guy who's boss on the 160 acres that I love. Up at dawn to beat the sun, I've forgotten what a care or worry means. Head for home when day is done, with my pocket money jingling in my jeans. I've got 160 acres full of sunshine, got 160 million stars above, got an old paid hoss. I'm the guy who's boss on the 160 acres that I love. Got an old paid hoss. I'm the guy who's boss on the 160 acres that I
It makes me sad and blue. Was on a rainy night like this that Flo said we were through. I told her how I loved her and I begged her not to go. But another man had changed her mind, so I said goodbye. Alone within my cell tonight, my heart is filled with fear. The only sound within the room is the falling of each tear. I think about the thing I've done, I know it wasn't right. They'll bury Flo tomorrow, but they're hanging me tonight. They're hanging me tonight. That night he came and took my Flo and headed into town. I knew I had to find this man and try to gun him down. As I walked by a dim cafe and I looked through the door, I saw my Flo with her new love, and I couldn't stand no more. I couldn't stand no more. I took my pistol from my hip and with a trembling hand, I took the life of pretty Flo and that good for nothing man. That good for nothing man. I think about the thing I've done, I know it wasn't right. They'll bury Flo tomorrow, but they're hanging me tonight. They're hanging me tonight.
I was hanging around town, just spending my time. Out of a job, not earning a dime. A feller steps up and he said, I suppose you're a bronc fighter from the looks of your clothes. You figures me right, I'm a good one I claim. Do you happen to have any bad ones to tame? Said he's got one, a bad one to buck. For throwing good riders, he's had lots of luck. I gets all head up and I ask what he pays to ride this old nag for a couple of days. He offered me 10 and I said, I'm your man. A bronc never lived that I couldn't fan. He said, get your saddle, I'll give you a chance. In his buckboard we hops and he drives to the ranch. I stayed until morning and right after chuck I stepped out to see if this outlaw can buck. Down in the horse corral standing alone is an old caballo, a strawberry roan. His legs are all spavined, he's got pigeon toes, little pig eyes and a big Roman nose, little pin ears that touch at the tip. A big 44 brand was on his left hip. U-neck and all with a long lower jaw, I could see with one eye he's a regular outlaw. I gets the blinds on him and it sure is a fright. Next comes my saddle and I screws it down tight. Then I steps on him and I raises the blind. Get out the way, boys, he's gonna unwind. He sure is a frog walker, he heaves a big sigh. He only likes wings for to be on the fly. He turns his old belly right up to the sun. He sure is a sunfish and son of a gun. He's about the worst bucker I've seen on the range. He'll turn on a nickel and give you some change. He hits on all fours and goes up on high. Leaves me a spinning up there in the sky. I turns over twice and I comes back to earth. I lights into cussing the day of his birth. I know there are ponies that I cannot ride. There's some of them left, they haven't all died. I'll bet all my money, the man he lied, that'll stay with old Strawberry when he makes his high dive.
I'm as sad as the willow that weeps in the valley. Since you've gone from my arms, I'm as sad as the cold wind that cries in the treetops. I'll be lonesome until you return. Come back. Cowboy's arms. I will weep like the willow that weeps in the valley. I'll be lonesome until you return. Come back, come back, come back to the valley. Cowboy's arms. I will weep like the willow that weeps in the valley. I'll be lonesome until you
man. I was wild and full of fire, a youth within my teens but full of challenge and desire. I ran away from home and left my mother and my dad. I know it grieved them so to think their only boy was bad. I fell in with an outlaw band, their names were known quite well. How many times we robbed and plundered I could never tell. This kind of sinful living leads only to a fall.
I learned that much and more the night I heard my master call. One night we rustled cattle, 1,000 head or so, and started them out on the trail that leads to Mexico. But a norther started blowing, and lightning flashed about. I thought someone was calling me, I thought I heard a shout. Then at that moment lightning struck not 20 yards from me, and left there was a giant cross where once there was a tree. And this time I knew I heard a voice so sweet and strange, a voice that came from everywhere, a voice that called my name. So frightened I was thinking of sinful deeds I'd done, I failed to see the 1,000 head of cattle start to run. The cattle they stampeded were running all around. My pony ran but stumbled and it threw me to the ground. I felt the end was near, that death would be the price, when a mighty bolt of lightning showed the face of Jesus Christ. And I cried, oh Lord, forgive me, don't let it happen now. I want to live for you alone, oh God, these words I vow. My rig had passed and folded, I thought of wasted years, when another bolt of lightning killed 100 head of steers. And the others rushed on by me, and I was left to live. The master had a reason, life is his to take or give. A miracle performed that night, I wasn't meant to die. The dead ones formed a barricade, at least 6 or 7 high. Right behind it there was I, afraid but safe and sound. I cried and begged for mercy, kneeling there upon the ground. A pardon I was granted, my sinful soul set free. No more to fear the angry waves upon life's stormy sea. Forgiven by the love of God, a love that will remain. I gave my life and soul the night the Savior called my name. Kansas City, going south to Mexico. I was running, dodging danger, left the girl that I loved so. Far behind lay Kansas City and the past that I had earned. 20 notches on my 6-gun mark, the lessons I had learned. Many times I sold my fast gun for a place to lay my head, till the nights begin to haunt me by the men that I left dead. Couldn't stand it any longer with this life that I'd begun, so I said goodbye to Dini and became a running gun. I rode into Amarillo as the sun sank in the west, my thoughts in Kansas City and the girl that I loved best. As I smiled and kissed her gently and then turned away to go, said I'd send for her to meet me when I'd reached old Mexico. I had barely left the saddle and my foot just touched the ground, when a cold voice from the shadows told me not to turn around. Said he knew about my fast gun, knew the price paid by the law, challenged by a bounty hunter, so I turned around to draw. I knew someday I'd meet him, for his hand like lightning flashed, my own gun stood in leather as his bullet tore its path. As my strength was slowly fading, I could see him walk away, and I knew that where I lie tonight, he too must lie someday. Now the crowd is slowly gathering, but my eyes are growing dim, and my thoughts return to Jeannie and the home that we had planned. Oh, please tell her, won't you, mister, that she's still the only one, but a woman's love is wasted when she loves a running gun. Running gun, running gun. I see a candlelight down in the little green valley, glory by
will trouble me no more.
There's only one thing ever gives me consolation, and that's the thought that I'll be going back someday.
And every night down upon my knees I pray the Lord to please take me back to that little low green valley far away. I hear a mockingbird down in the little green valley. He's singing out a song of welcome just for me. Someone waits by the garden gate down in the little green valley. When I get back again, how happy she will be.
And by a little babbling brook once more we'll wander, and in a shady nook we'll dream the hours away.
I will leave all my cares behind, go where I know I'll find sunshine, back to that little low green valley far away.
And now, my friends, you've asked me what makes me sad and still, and why my brow is darkened like the clouds upon the hill. Run in your ponies closer, and I'll tell to you my tale of Utah Care, my partner, and his last ride on the trail. We rode the range together and rode it side by side. I loved him like a brother, and I wept when Utah died. We were rounding up one morning when work was almost done, when on his side the cattle started on a frightened run. Underneath the saddle that the boss's daughter rode, Utah that very morning had placed a bright red robe, so the saddle might ride easy for Lenore, his little friend. And it was this red blanket that brought him to his end. The blanket was now dragging behind her on the ground. The frightened cattle saw it and charged it with a bound. Lenore then saw her danger and turned her pony's face, and leaning in the saddle, tied the blanket to its place. But in leaning, lost her balance, fell in front of that wild tide. Lay still, Lenore, I'm coming, were the words that Utah cried. His faithful pony saw her and reached her with a bound. I thought he'd been successful and raised her from the ground. But the weight upon the saddle had not been felt before. His back since snapped like thunder, and he fell by Lenore. Picking up the blanket, he swung it o'er his head and started across the prairie. Lay still, Lenore, he said. When he got the stampede turned and saved Lenore, his friend, then turned to face the cattle and meet his fatal end. His six gun flashed like lightning, the report rang loud and clear. As the cattle rushed and killed him, he dropped the leading steer. On his funeral morning, I heard the preacher say, I hope we'll all meet Utah at the roundup far away. Then they wrapped him in a blanket that saved his little friend. And it was this red blanket
that brought him to his end.
Elijah was a wooden Indian standing by the door. He fell in love with the Indian maiden over in the antique store. Elijah, too stubborn to ever let it show, so she could never answer yes and no. He always wore his Sunday feathers and held a tomahawk. The maiden wore her beads and braids and hoped someday he'd talk. Elijah, too stubborn to ever show a sign, because his heart was made of knotty pine. Poor old Elijah, he never got a kiss. Poor old Elijah, he don't know what he missed. Is there any wonder that his face is red? Elijah, that poor old wooden head. Elijah was a lonely Indian, never went nowhere. His heart was set on the Indian maiden with the coal black hair. Elijah just stood there and never let it show, so she could never answer yes or no. And then one day a wealthy customer bought the Indian maid and took her oh so far away, but old Elijah stayed. Elijah, too stubborn to ever show a sign, because his heart was made of knotty pine. Poor old Elijah, he never got a kiss. Poor old Elijah, he don't know what he missed. Is there any wonder that his face is red? Elijah, that poor old wooden head.
I came to town to search for gold, and I brought with me a memory. And I seem to hear the nightingale cry, go hang your dreams on the hanging tree, your dreams of love that could never be. Hang your faded dreams on the hanging tree. I searched for gold, and I found my gold. And I found a girl who loved just me. And I wished that I could love her too. But I'd left my heart on the hanging tree. I left my heart with the memory. And a faded dream on the hanging tree. There were men who craved my gold and meant to take my gold from me. When a man is gone, he needs no gold. So they carried me to the hanging tree to join my dreams and a memory. Yes, they carried me to the hanging tree. Must almost die, and it happened just that way with me. They took the gold and set me free, and I walked away from the hanging tree. I walked away from the hanging tree, and my own true love, she walked with me. That's when I knew that the hanging tree was a tree of life, new life for me. A tree of a hope, new hope for me. A tree of love, new love for me. The hanging tree,
the hanging tree,
the hanging tree,
They call me a drifter, they say I'm no good, I'll never amount to a thing. Well, I may be a drifter and it may be no good, there's joy in this song that I sing. Saddle tramp, I'm as free as the breeze and I ride where I please. Saddle tramp, at night I will rest neath a blanket of blue, doubt if I ever will change. I might even dream of a lady I knew, might even whisper her name. Saddle tramp, I'm as free as the breeze and I ride where I please. Saddle tramp, I might even wind up in Idaho and visit a cute little miss, a sweet little someone I used to know, and I might even stop long enough for a kiss. Saddle tramp, I'm as free as the breeze and I ride where I please. Saddle tramp, might even ride back through Phoenix someday, might even stop for a while. But branded, no, never, I'll not be tied down, trapped by a fair lady's smile. Saddle tramp, I'm as free as the breeze and I ride where I please. Saddle tramp.
From this valley, they say, miss your bright eyes and sweet smile. For you take with you all of the sunshine that has brightened our pathway a while. Then come sit by my side if you love me. Do not hasten to bid me adieu. Just remember the Red River Valley and the cowboy that's loved you so true. For a long time, my darling, I've waited for the sweet words you never stand by my side if you love me. Do not hasten to bid me adieu. Just remember the Red River Valley and the cowboy that's loved you so.
In the southern part of Texas, in the town of San Antone, is a fortress all in ruins that the weeds have overgrown. You may look in vain for crosses and you'll never see a one, but sometimes between the setting and the rising of the sun, you can hear a ghostly bugle as the men go marching by. You can hear them as they answer to that roll call in the sky. Colonel Travis, Davy Crockett, and 180 more, Captain Dickinson, Jim Bowie, present and accounted for. Back in 1836, Houston said to Travis, get some volunteers and go, fortify the Alamo. Well, the men came from Texas and from old Tennessee, and they joined up with Travis just to fight for the right to be free. Indian scouts with squirrel guns, men with muzzle loaders, stood together heel and toe to defend the Alamo. You may ne'er see your loved ones, Travis told them that day. Those who want to can leave now, those who fight to the death let them stay. In the sand he drew a line with his army saber. Out of 185, not a soldier crossed the line. With his banners a-dancing in the dawn's golden light, Santa Anna came prancing on a horse that was black as the night. Sent an officer to tell Travis to surrender. Travis answered with a shell and a rousing rebel yell. Santa Anna turned scarlet, played to Quaylo, he roared, I will show them no quarter, everyone will be put to the sword. 185, holding back 5,000. 5 days, 6 days, 8 days, 10, Travis held and held again. Then he sent for replacements for his wounded and lame, but the troops that were coming never came, never came, never came. Twice he charged, then blew recall on the fatal third time. Santa Anna breached the wall and he killed them one and all. Now the bugles are silent and there's rust on each sword, and the small band of soldiers lie asleep in the arms of the Lord.
the southern part of Texas, near the town of San Antonio. Like a statue on his pintle rides a cowboy all alone. And he sees the cattle grazing where a century before Santa Ana's guns were blazing and the cannons used to roar. And his eyes turn sort of misty and his heart begins to glow. And he takes his hat off slowly to the men of Alamo, to the 13 days. North of the border of old Mexico, I rode one day to the cow town of San Angelo. A hot sun was glowing, a hot breeze was blowing, still not as warm as the lips that I waited to kiss. She sent a message a long time ago. Socorro had promised to meet me in San Angelo. I was aware of the chance I was taking. I was an outlaw, but great was my love for this girl.
I must be with her, I can't stay away. Nights spent without her are lonely, and so are the days. If it means death, then I'll have to chance it. Only a few minutes more and she'll be at my side. At 10 o'clock in the morning, I tied my horse and I started to walk down the street. Where was Socorro? Had she forgotten? This was the day and the hour that she wanted to be. But something is wrong with our plans, and I hear death awaits me. Here on this hot, dusty street,
up on a housetop, but still I can see, there hides a man with the rifle, it's pointed at me. I might escape from the man with the rifle, but there are others just like him that I cannot see.
Back of each window, the click of a gun. Die if I stay, and my love for her won't let me run. Where is Socorro? Will my eyes see her? Then in a moment she runs from the door down the street. Up on your horse she is crying. Right out of town it's a trap and they're waiting for you. But if I ride up, she must ride with me. Then in a moment I know that our chances are gone. For a bullet is well on its way, and it finds my Socorro. She cries as she falls in my arms.
Over and over her soft lips did say, now we're together, I won't let them take you away. One little sigh, her little lips trembled, then it was over, Socorro had drifted away.
Dimmed in my vision, but plainly I see, the ranger that killed her is standing there waiting for me. I rise to meet him, my one thought is beating. He deserves death, and I swear that this ranger will die. I beat his draw and I shot him. Shot him six times just as fast as the bullets could fly. My gun is empty or more I will shoot him. Now there are others just like him that want me to die. Their bullets are coming my way. Pain makes me fall to the ground.
Gone is my strength, just the will left to fight. I hear the sound of the lead as it robs me of life. If I must die, let me find Socorro. Let me hold on to her hand for the few moments left. Blindly I search and it isn't in vain. I touch the soft velvet hand and it eases the pain.
Life is no more, but we're together. Even in death she's my lover, it's over.
Driving a herd of cattle out in old Nebraska way, heading east at Broken Bow on a hot September day. Trying to get to Omaha, we hoped to find a buyer. We never counted in the odds of a western prairie fire. A hot south wind was blowing and the air was getting dry. Something far away was spelling trouble in the sky. Coming closer was a sound that topped the devil's choir. Then we knew we'd have to race a raging prairie fire.
At the sky, and every heart is quickened, and the spirit every eye. We've just one chance to get away, for there's no place to hide. Gotta reach the River Platte, one inch deep and 1 mile wide.
The herd is getting tired, but we've got no time to rest. I try to clear the red dust that is gathering in my chest. From riding tail on a thousand head with the weather getting dry, the black cloud in the west is warning,
ride, ride, ride. The roaring heat is closer, ashes falling by our side, and every beast and bird is fleeing with its warning cry. We've got to reach the river, but it's still 10 miles or more, and close behind us we can hear that wild inferno roar.
But fate had other plans, for we lost that fatal race. We lost, for neither man nor beast could long keep up the pace. The mighty Platte subdued its rage, but none were there to rest. We did our best to get away, but only I am bad.
Now on the blackened prairie, far as the eye can see, the grim remains are there to show that God rules you and me. Just one he left to tell the tale, just one was his desire. We lost a herd and 30 men to a raging prairie fire.
As I walked out in the streets of Laredo, as I walked out in Laredo one day, I spied a young cowboy wrapped all in white linen, wrapped in white linen as cold as the clay. Oh, beat the drum slowly and play the fife lowly. Sing the death march as you carry me along. Take me to the valley, there lay the sod o'er me. I'm a young cowboy and know I've did say as I boldly walked by, come sit down beside me and hear my sad story. Got shot in the breast and I know I must die. Go fetch me some water, a cool cup of water, to cool my parched lips, then the poor cowboy said. Before I returned, his spirit had left him, had gone to his maker, the cowboy was dead. Oh, beat the drum slowly and play the fife lowly. Sing the death march as you carry me along. Take me to the valley, there lay the sod o'er me. I'm a young cowboy and know I've done wrong.
Long, long ago, an old Wyoming lived a maid, fair as the sweetest flower blooming in the shade. She loved a bandit bold who roamed the prairie o'er, and every night she'd listen for his call. Then far to the west his voice came ringing, riding a wild horse he came singing, heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ay.
Heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ip-i-oly-ay. He brings talking Heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ay.
One day he rode away, but never to return. Danger was waiting, now his love must never yearn. Long days and lonely nights she waited all in vain, till winter passed and summer came again. Still every night when the moon came shining, for his song her heart was pining. Heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ay.
Heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ip-i-oly-ay. He brings token of his love, swift as the wind he goes far high in the hills, and all she's waiting for his heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ay.
One night an angel brought a message from her love, told her he waited in the starlit sky above. Softly she closed her eyes and bade the angel go, and then the whole world echoed to his song. For straight down a moonbeam he came riding, out of the sky on a winged horse gliding. Heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ay.
Heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ip-i-oly-ay. He brings token of his love, swift as the wind he goes for high in the hills, he knows she's waiting for his heely-oly-ip-i-oly-ay.
I've got no use for the women, a true one may seldom be found. They'll use a man for his money, when it's gone they'll turn him down. They're all alike at the bottom, selfish and grasping for all. They'll stay by a man when he's winning, and laugh in his face when he falls. My pal was an honest young puncher, honest and upright and true, till he turned to a gun-shooting gambler on account of a girl named Lou. They they fell in with evil companions, the kind that are better off dead. When a gambler insulted her picture, he filled him full of lead. All through the long night they trailed him, through mesquite and thick chaparral. I couldn't help think of that woman as I saw him pitch and fall. If she'd been the pal that she should have, he might have been raising a son instead of out there on the prairie to die by a ranger's gun. Death's sharp sting did not trouble, his chances for life were too slim. Where they were putting his body was all that worried him. He lifted his head on his elbow, the blood from his wound flowed red. He gazed at his friends gathered round him, he looked up at them and he said, bury me out on the prairie, where the coyotes can howl o'er my grave. Bury me out on the prairie, but from them my bones please save. Wrap me up in a blanket, bury me deep in the ground. Cover me over with boulders of granite big and brown. We buried him out on the prairie, where the coyotes can howl o'er his grave. His soul is now resting from the unkind cut she gave. And many another young puncher, as he rides past the pile of stones, recalls some similar woman and thinks of his moldering bones.
Five brothers who left Arkansas set out to find the gambler who murdered their paw. Five brothers and three in their teens gotta find the man who killed their paw in New Orleans. They heard of him in Houston and his trail was leading west. He'd left there many months ago and so they couldn't rest. Five brothers and three in their teens gotta find the man who killed their paw in New Orleans. New Orleans. The sun was hot as fire and the nights were cold as steel. Hate was strong and youth was wild and so they couldn't feel. Five brothers and three in their teens gotta find the man who killed their pa in New Orleans. His trail led to the Badlands and the desert promised death. The gambler's odds were different now, he treasured every breath. Five brothers and three in their teens, close behind the man who killed their pa in New Orleans. New Orleans. When first they saw the killer, he was by a water hole. Five rifles rang out through the night, they killed the gambler cold. Five brothers and three in their teens, finally got the man who killed their pa in New Orleans. Desert is their keeper now, for this a traveler said, that poison lived within the hole, now six of them are dead. Five brothers and three in their teens lay beside the man who killed their pa in New Orleans. Lay beside the man who killed their pa in New Orleans.
Little Joe the wrangler will wrangle nevermore. His days with the roundup they are o'er. Was a year ago last April.
April when he rode into our camp. Just a little Texas stray and nothing more. Was late in the evening when he rode into our camp on a little Texas pony he called Chore. With his broken shoes and overalls, a tougher looking kid you never in your life before had saw. His saddle was a Texas cag built many years ago, an OK spur on one foot lightly swung. With his pack rolled in a cotton sack so loosely tied behind, and a canteen from his saddle horn was slung. He said he had to leave his home, his pa had married twice, his new ma whipped him every day or two. So he saddled up old Jaw one night and lit a chuck this way. He said he'd try to paddle his own canoe. He said if we would give him work, he'd do the best he could, though he didn't know straight up about a cow. So the boss, he cut him out a mount and kindly put him on. He's sort of like this little kid somehow. He learned to wrangle horses and learned to know them all and get them in at daybreak if he could, and to trail the old chuck wagon and always hitch the team and help the cook each evening rustle wood. We had hardly reached the Pecos, the weather it was fine. We were camped down on the south side in a draw, when a norther commenced blowing and we doubled up our guards. It took every one of us to hold them in. Little Joe the wrangler was called out with the rest. Scarcely had the little fellow reached the herd when the cattle they stampeded like a hailstorm on they fled, and everyone was riding for the lead. Amidst the streaks of lightning, there was one horse up ahead. He was trying to check the leaders in their speed. It was Little Joe the wrangler with a slicker o'er his head. He was riding Old Blue Rocket in the lead. At last we got them milling and kind of quieted down, and the extra guards back to the wagon went. But there was one a-missing, we could see it at a glance, was our little Texas stray poor wrangler Joe. Next morning just at daybreak we found where Rocket fell, down in a washout 20 feet below. Beneath his horse his life was gone, his spur had rung its knell, was our little Texas stray poor wrangler Joe. Ride, cowboy, ride, don't ride too slow. Tucson's a mighty long way yet to go. He started his long ride in Prescott. The sun was 100 or more. On down he rode at full gallop into the flat desert floor. Driving the big herd to Flagstaff, in Prescott the letter was there. Happiness soon would be sorrow, sad news the letter did bear. Ride, cowboy, ride, don't go too slow. Ride, cowboy, ride, you've a long way to go. Your darling now lies on her deathbed, racked by fever and pain. Reach
reaching for you at her bedside, and each breath she's caught in your name. Forward he leaned in the saddle, pushing through mesquite and sage, his head never raised for a greeting as he passed the Wickenburg stage. Ride, cowboy, ride, don't ride too slow. Tucson's a mighty long way yet to go. In Phoenix he traded horses, now on the back of this road he could see visions of Tucson, his darling and their lovely home. Ride, cowboy, ride, don't ride too slow. There's still 120 to go. In through the ranch gate he galloped, and without breaking his stride, he bounded out of the saddle and rushed to his sweet darling's side. Then as the dying girl saw him, a smile came over her face, holding her hand as it tightened. Barely had he won the race. Ride, cowboy, ride on through the blue. Ride, cowboy, ride, she'll be waiting for you. Ride, cowboy, ride on through the blue. Ride, cowboy, ride, she'll be waiting. I'm just a poor cowboy singing his song. No money to jingle as I ride along. I'm rejected by men but accepted above. I belong in this valley, on this sod. Let me ride from the mountains to the dark rolling sea. I'm broke, but I'm wealthy because I am free. Let me walk in this valley where my fathers have trod. Let me live forever. On this land till I'm withered and old, till I'm meek and I'm humbled and the Lord wants my soul. Let me live in this valley where my fathers have trod. Let me live forever on this peaceful sod. She was young and she was pretty. She was warm and tender too. Could ask for, but her heart could not be true. No, her heart could not be true. Eyes that sparkled just like diamond, lips as fresh as morning dew. She was young and she was fickle,
and her heart could not be true. No, her heart could not be true. Cheeks just like a rose when blooming, and a form so fine and rare. Curls that hung below her shoulders, gold the color of her hair. Now she's gone, no one can claim her. In my cell I'm sad. One bright night I shot and killed her. She was young and so untrue. She was young and so untrue. One bright night I watched another kiss her like I used to do. So I drew my gun and killed her. She was young and so untrue. In the morning, just at daybreak, when the roses kiss the dew, I shall hang because I killed her. She was young and so untrue. She was young and so untrue. My love is the valley, the breezes that sigh. My love is the mountains that reach to the sky. My love is the valley, the rocks and the rills. My love is the prairie, the low rolling hills, the low rolling hills. The call of the night bird, I love every trill. There's peace and contentment when everything's still. The wail of the coyote, the flight of the dove, it's all God's creation, and that's I love, and that's what I
begin in Reynosa, a village in old Mexico. A girl and a Mexican soldier were sweethearts a long time ago. They made big plans for a wedding. The town of Reynosa would go, and they would see Jimmy Martinez married to Sarah Soro. Came a message, it said that Jimmy must go, that Jimmy was leaving Reynosa to fight at the Alamo. He never returned to Reynosa, the
but stories been told and retold. How Jimmy the Mexican soldier died at the Alamo. Last letter to Sarah to begin with a message like this. Oh dear one, how sweet is the memory of our parting kiss. I send my heart in this letter, I pray to the one up above. Oh Sarah, don't ever forget me, stay just as pure as the dove. The dove in your window, it's chosen, just one made for life. And you are the one I have chosen, the one that I want for my wife. He never returned to Reynosa, the story's been told and retold. How Jimmy the Mexican soldier died at the Alamo. Jimmy's return, and there every night in her window a small little candle would burn. Years turned her dark hair to silver, she prayed for Jimmy so long. Then one night the village was saddened, the light in her window was gone.
West in Arizona, cowboy tends a herd. The desert lies beneath the sky of blue. Far away in brightest day, a ghostly sound is heard. The phantom of the rail comes into view.
Hear that lonesome whistle calling. On his lonely ear is falling. Loud and clear. Just hear that lonesome wail. But it's just the ghost, the phantom of the rail.
Little did he know the train was wrecked in 84 after it had crossed the Great Divide. Every year it tries again to make it just once more, if only to the California line.
Hear that lonesome whistle calling on the barren desert falling. Loud and clear, just hear that lonesome wail. But it's just a ghost, the phantom of the rail.
Clickety-clack along the track, its border showing red, as on it comes along the rusty rails. People that are riding in the cars have long been dead, lost in time along the phantom trail.
Hear that lonesome whistle calling on the barren desert falling. Is it real to feel the very ground beneath him shake? As on it comes, the only run it ever made.
Closer comes the phantom as his eyes in wonder gaze. His pony shies and heads him for the brush. And as it comes upon him, terror grips his heart amazed, leaping to avoid its onward rush.
Hear that lonesome whistle calling on the bell.
on staying on the ghost train rail.
Another bend I can't see, and the bend that keeps calling is the bend that keeps hiding from me. Past the first hill on the desert is another hill I can't see, and the hill that keeps hiding is the hill that keeps calling to me. In the cottonwood by the river, a mourning dove calls his mate. He has true love to give her, but love for me must wait till I've traveled every river and each desert hill I have climbed. If I find love to my liking, I'll leave the river's bend far behind.
All you young cowboys, come gather around, I'll tell you a story of Abilene Town. Of two young lovers, as true lovers know, the girl in the story is Abilene Rose.
Rose, Rose, Abilene Rose, your memory still lives in my heart. Rose, Abilene Rose, we promised we never would part.
Rose was so pretty in her gingham gown, she was the fairest in Abilene Town. Her eyes were as bright as the stars up above, everyone knew when she chose me to love.
Rose, Rose, Abilene Rose, your memory still lives in my heart. Rose, Abilene, promised we never would part.
We courted each other out under the moon, we planned to be married the first day of June. Then I started drinking and gambling, you see, I broke her young heart and then she left me.
Rose, Rose, Abilene Rose, your memory still lives in my heart. Rose, Abilene Rose, we promised we never would part.
I got into trouble and had to leave town. Rose got married and then settled down. She was as happy could be, with her young cowboy and their family.
Rose, Rose, Abilene Rose, your memory still lives in my heart. Rose.
we never will part.
This is the story I promised to tell. All you young cowboys, remember it well. If you find true love, don't tear it apart. Marry that true love, don't break her young heart.
Rose, Rose, Abilene Rose, your memory still lives in my heart. Rose, Abilene Rose, forever we must live apart.
Ninety days since the country's seen a drop of rain. 44 since the grass began to burn. Thirsty cattle are milling round the old creek bed. Dusty winds where the waters used to churn.
Dusty winds, hear them blow. Dusty winds moan and low. Night and day on they go, those dusty winds.
Not a cloud in the sky, but still the sun shines dim. But enough to turn the scenery dark and brown. Looking westward is a dust cloud looming high in the sky. Shows the trail of 50 settlers leaving town.
Dusty winds, hear them blow. Dusty winds moan and low. Night and day on they go, those dusty winds.
When it's late in the evening in my cabin all alone, it's so lonesome when that wind comes howling through. And I think of all the settlers heading west out of town. Kinda wished I'd have left here with them too.
Dusty winds, hear them blow. Dusty winds moan and low, night and day on they go, those dusty winds.
The days of my youth I remember so well. We lived in a world all our own. Nobody cared where my money came from. If I had it, I wasn't alone.
All the wine flowed freely and friendship was mine. How they all loved me back then.
But here in my prison I'm sitting alone. And now where are all of my friends? So drink and be merry if that is your wish. Your souls to the Lord I commend. Remember someday you may be as I am, with nothing, not even a friend.
Oh, the wine flowed freely and friendship was mine. How they all loved me back then.
But here in my prison I'm sitting alone. And now where are all of my friends? So here's to the freedom I never will have. For me it's not long till the end. But it's better to die than to spend 40 years with a cold prison walls for a friend.
Oh, the wine flowed freely and friendship was mine. How they all loved me back then.
But here in my prison